interaction with yourselves, because he understands that his ministry will succeed because of the effort of this province, which is productive. You raise issues to do with issues to do with industrialization in the province. We agree with you and we hear you. And this is sitting squarely well with the vision of His Excellency, where He has directed us, especially as provincial ministers, to say, go and open up provinces. And He has given us a heavier load than ministers running nine ministries. Because He has said He wants to shift power and resources from the center of Lusaka to devolve into the provinces, into the districts, into the constituency. And you will soon see when the budget is announced that the president is walking the talk, because the budget will come to speak to what the president has been pronouncing himself about. So, issues to do with value addition has to be done here. Not all produce we produce here. We can do value addition. And thank you also for indicating that some of the challenges we face, actually, we can mitigate them ourselves. For instance, you can say, you can put resources together and come up with a deal, come up with an industry, so that you begin to write for power, for instance. And you are comparative advantage, because you are going to be producing from local organized resources. So I think that call by the choma should be taken serious. Because how do you sell milk to Lusaka? Then the same milk Lusaka brings it back to choma to sell to your people at a higher price. It means you are shipping jobs from this province. You are shipping jobs and money. This also goes to some of the challenges that this particular community is faced with and the province, particularly as provincial capital. Look at the capacity you have here in this afternoon. We don't have a meaningful hotel here in the provincial capital, such that our flagship carrier football team, Choma Eagles, when they host continental games, they have to go and play away from Choma, because we don't have accommodation to meet the required standard. Yet, the business people of Choma have capacity to come together and register an agent and say, Minister, take us to DPZ, take us to this new ministry where CEC is now sitting. We are quite alone. This is the net value of our funds, our businesses, our other properties as collateral. Put up a 5-star hotel here in Choma. It's a provincial capital. You will recover your money. So we must begin to look into inward solutions before we look outside. Issues to do with business licenses, we take note of the authority that mentioned. Taxes. Yeah, thank you. It's a reminder. Taxes. Just like you want, you pay to receive a call. So, we hear you, we take note. And I think whoever has spoken, I have taken down 13 points here, which we are going now together with the GPS for those who are writing, to consolidate into action points that we are going to begin to work on. Starting today, way from here, we say we are going police over commercial poaching. But after the meeting, me and the Bruce here, we have another meeting. Thank you very much. The mayor, who is the boss, cannot go away without say something. The minister.
Thank you, Honourable Minister. I will not actually digress from the discussion we had today, only to reaffirm the community of Choma through you, Honourable Minister, that as a local authority, we will still maintain our open door policy to everyone for whatever reasons that they might need to interact with us. I'm aware also, Honourable Minister, I should allude to the fact that we still have outstanding issues that we never actually concluded in our last term due to one or two issues. So we are making an undertaking that we shall be able to conclude. And this has been a good consultation. Even as a local authority, we actually do periodic consultations, and we shall be able to do that. Honourable Minister, the issues that I needed to respond to, particularly licensing and cost of doing business, and maybe inside trade. For licensing fees, Honourable Minister, we are bound by statutory instruments. So the local authority does not actually generate what SME or a business entity should pay. It's something derived from the statutory instrument, from Ministry of Commerce or whichever line ministry. However, I should also take the blame because we've seen quite some high staff turnover where new staff are coming on a monthly basis, which is one thing we should endeavor to end as a new non-government. But each time we have a new staff, they're grappling to settle into their new roles, and I think we've had you and myself, business community, come in to say, last year we were paying so much, how come all of a sudden we're paying this much? And I think we've resolved that, and I'm making an earnest call to the business community that if you still have such a problem, my office is available to resolve such at any time. We've not actually changed anything this far. And we will actually be making a follow-up, because the president has told us to reduce the cost of doing business. And the cost of doing business is actually anchored on levies, taxes, as has been alluded. Finally, Honourable Minister, you also being a member of parliament for Choma Central, you were talking about us having a five-star hotel. If in the new Dawn government we are able to do the urban roads, we are able to lobby for a five-star hotel and a cathedral. We see nothing standing between us transforming from a municipality into a city by 2026. So we should be able to become a crew. I should actually intimate and say that I'm one of the largest mayors who would actually, if the minister is busy, I'll still walk to his home because he's minister in MP in the district that I'm mayor, and we should be able to resolve this. To everyone, I look forward to a good working relationship with yourselves. We have the crop of new and old councillors. We should be able to interact. If there is any challenge, our doors are still open 24/7, and we should be able to respond to any particular things. But like the minister has said, we have also taken note of what needs to be done for the local authority. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor. Yes, I just wanted to end by extending what the mayor has said and adopting it as my own, that going forward, we look forward to more such meetings, consultative and interactive meetings. We have had a lot this afternoon, and already I do have a sense of relief that it is easier actually to run a promise when you are running it with everyone. So we will continue to report to from time to time so that we can hold such interactive meetings. But in between these meetings, If there is anything that you think requires urgent attention to help you in your businesses, please do not hesitate to call on us. It might be something to do with Lusaka and decision being made in Lusaka in ministries. Please feel free to call on us so that we are able to assist, so that you don't go to an officer here and told to say, wait, the queue of appointments. So you have no appointments in the poor choma. When you start, just reach out to me. If there's something you need to be done, here. And finally, since I'm the chief novice of this province, we have a provincial action this Friday at the stadium where we are calling on primarily the choma community, but to include all other people in the province to come and celebrate the new dawn administration and the victory that you, the people, decided to give to yourselves. So it will be on Friday, starting here, I think it's 12 hours, and we will be happy to see you, all of you. Well, I see now, I've written down the things that I'll take you all to come, and I'll come to the back. It will be nice to have all of you at that function, which will be for Friday. And I know some of you already have made contributions to that function, so that it comes to fruition, because it's the function that is being funded by the local community. Although it is being arranged by the provincial administration, we are saying in the national budget, there was no line to begin to hold functions to celebrate, so we don't want to have anything to do with public funds. The local community should be able to celebrate their own victory. So thank you so very much for those of you who have already made contributions. Others are yet to make contributions. For those of you who are collecting such contributions, or who have collected such contributions, the third group of prudence, accountability, and transparency equally apply. Whatever you get along from a commercial partner, from a business person, this administration will have to write back to all those who contributed. Now, if someone says, I contributed, where did my contribution go? Those who collected will have to answer. Square. Thank you so much, and may God bless you for it.
Thank you very much, Mr. Minister. All of you who raised you to head the valid function, we want to show the country that we have received the provincial minister who has been the member of parliament for Choma Central, and also to show the country that the people of Choma have turned up to hear a message, because the provincial minister will be communicating a message from his excellence on how the president is feeling for what the people of Choma did. So, like the honorable minister said, provincial administration is coordinating, because we don't want to hear that any contribution which was made to this function was not accounted for. So, honorable minister, the provincial accountant has nominated one accountant to attach to the organizing committee, and also the head procurement has attached a procurement officer. These two have accountability issues to do with one money, the other one physical goods that are donated in kind, and to ensure that there is a record for all the donations that will come, so that as the minister will be writing in the injured to you, we shall not miss a single person that will have contributed. So we have already done the letters, and we attach what the organizing committee has put as requisites. Then you will decide in your own strength what you can put up. This function, we are calling on all our members of parliament for Southern Province, including the two cabinet ministers who are coming from Southern Province. They have to come from Lusaka, because we have to celebrate. This is the provincial capital. We have to celebrate and ensure that we replicate that feeling in ourselves. I don't know that why someone was told here, the name. The one who has been. Mr. Prince? Yes. I want to ask him, Honorable Minister, as we open the floor for you to demonstrate some skills. The Honorable Minister is a sportsman. So don't look at the way he walks slowly like this. He's very fit. So he can equally dance. So we thank you. We will send the letter in the same manner that we sent the invitation letter. So business, the chairman for Chamber of Commerce, business community, and the chairman for the... So we will send to the three of you. Then each one of you will share with your members. The contact person will be